Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American markets using weekly charts. Now, if you were with us this time last weekend, we were watching the VIX, which came into the week on a sell signal. That, of course, is bullish for higher stock prices. At that time, we were looking for the VIX to stay below 22.50 Friday afternoon at 4 p.m., and that's certainly what happened. The VIX continued to move lower, down 4% on the week, and now we've got the upper trend line starting to roll over, and so this coming Friday, we're going to remain bullish on the markets until we see a close above $21.98. Now, I don't want to make too much of this, but my confidence level is very low at the moment. And the reason for that is we're seeing a huge divergence in the price of fear and the price of stocks. You can see that the fear index or the VIX index has dropped quite a bit over the past few months, but we haven't seen a corresponding rise in the stock market. So options traders are valuing risk at the moment one way. Stock traders in New York are valuing the opportunity of owning stocks another way. And until those get balanced out, I'm really not going to get excited about the stock market. And so confidence is still low. The S&P 500, the Dow both closed lower last week, while the NASDAQ was slightly higher, and the SOX index also traded higher, but certainly down at the bottom of the channel. Now, what I'm really concerned about, of course, is the financials, and they made a lower low last week and closed down 1.55% on the week. So that's not very helpful going forward. And we've been seeing a lot of gains from energy stocks over the last 4 weeks, but that stopped this week with the energy index just basically unchanged, up 3 cents on the week. So not a lot of excitement there. And then as a side note, the price of gold came down, and the gold stocks actually came down as well. Recovered nicely off the lows of the week, but still closed lower for the second week in a row. Now, looking north of the border, the TSX moved up. It's on a buy signal right now. And a lot of the gains that we've seen recently have been from the energy sector. And we're looking for other people to participate. We're looking for more money and wider money, so more diversified money to enter the market. But you can see here that the financial services index closed lower, as did the telecom sector. So Bell, Rogers, Telus, those big stocks closed lower on the week by just under 1%. And energy stocks stopped on a dime. We've been talking about the $200 level for a while now. We closed at 198.93, and so that $200 area of resistance is still holding this sector in check. So it's a very limited rally. Gold stocks have been treading water the last couple of weeks. The global mining sector was up on the week, but remember, a lot of stocks in this particular index are actually foreign stocks and not Canadian stocks. Now, quick look at commodities. Gold was down $7.60 on the week, ending the week on a sell signal, while crude oil moved higher and just coming up to the $70 level. Of course, that's a big round number, and $69.97 was the high of the week. If we can break out above $70, then $75 is our next target to the upside. And natural gas not really helping last week, down on the week 2.17%, still on a weekly sell signal, so no joy there. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. The VIX is on a sell signal. That should be helpful for higher stock prices, but that's not what's happening at the moment. Yeah, we're getting a rally in the technology sector. A lot of that is off earnings, Apple making new all-time highs. So that's certainly helpful for the NASDAQ, but the rest of the market is just stuttering at the moment. And until that changes, until the VIX and the major indices get back in sync, I'm not overly confident that we're going to see a huge rally from here. Have a great day, folks. Thank you very much for your time and attention. It's very much appreciated. The next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning, and at that time we'll take a closer look at the U.S. stock market.